In the last module, we explored ways to assess your internship options. During this process, you probably already noticed some interesting differences between career sectors in terms of employers' expectations of new hires and how they relate to potential interns. In this lecture, we will further situate your internships into the larger universe of institutions, organizations, and workplaces, including government, nonprofit, and corporate settings. What are the typical industry cultures embedded in each of these sectors? What are the expectations, challenges, and anticipated rewards associated with each? In his January 1961 inaugural speech, President John Kennedy declared, "Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country." With these words, President Kennedy inspired a whole generation of young people to public service. That generation is beginning to retire at a time when the need for public sector workers remains acute. America faces new challenges posed by a war on terrorism and its increasingly complex role in world affairs. In response to these new challenges, President Barack Obama has renewed the call for young people to serve, and evidence suggests that at least in the national security realm, people are answering that call. In most countries, including the U.S., governments are organized in a multi-tier structure. For example, in the U.S., we have a national or federal government, state governments, and local entities, including counties and cities. In Britain, you see a two-tiered system of national and local authorities. What do government workers do? Simply put, they do everything that private sector workers do, and more. For example, government employees hold positions as accountants, administrative assistants, bookkeepers, librarians, computer specialists, data analysts, lawyers, project managers, environmental technicians, communications and media specialists, and countless other positions. Over the last several decades, state and local governments have increased their activities in response to a significant rise in the U.S. population and a shift in program funding and responsibilities from the national government to state and local jurisdictions. State and local governments currently provide a host of services to residents, including education, transportation, utilities, police, courts, and probation. There are numerous employment opportunities in the 50 state governments, approximately 3,000 county governments, 19,000 municipal governments, 16,000 townships, and 14,000 school districts. For many people, government employment offers significant benefits. First, government employees enjoy comparatively good benefits, including paid vacation and sick leave, paid holidays, medical insurance, retirement plans, and often tuition assistance. In addition, government employees often enjoy a greater job security than private sector workers. While government jobs are not guaranteed, they are usually more insulated from the normal business cycles and temporary economic setbacks that can result in the loss of private sector jobs. Nonprofits. What exactly are these? Nonprofit organizations promote causes or provide public services in numerous areas. This includes the environment, social services, arts and culture, economic development, education, and science-based research. Nonprofits are different than private corporations or businesses that sell products or provide services to generate profits for their owners or shareholders. Instead, nonprofits are funded through grants from governments, private sector corporations, philanthropic foundations, wealthy individuals, through membership dues or fees for services, and various other fundraising activities. Currently, there are over 1 million nonprofit organizations in the U.S. that collectively employ over 10 million people. There are thousands of other nonprofits called non-governmental organizations operating around the globe. Non-governmental organizations respond to natural disasters, provide basic services in war-torn areas, and promote rights such as free speech or self-determination, among many other things. The wide range of nonprofit organizations can seem overwhelming to students who are seriously considering a career in nonprofits. Therefore, it's helpful to find ways to narrow down your search for internship opportunities, but also employment opportunities upon graduation. The basic distinction between issues and skills offers one way to organize your exploration of nonprofit careers. The nonprofit sector includes many people who are driven by a particular issue they feel strongly about, and who are less concerned about which particular position they fill at any given time. If you are driven primarily by an interest in an issue such as the environment, women's rights, child health, or arts advocacy, you should learn as much as you can about organizations that promote specific variants of those issues. Be sure to consider your options at different levels, including international, national, state, and locally based nonprofits. Many nonprofits, such as the World Wildlife Federation and the American Cancer Society, have headquarters that coordinate the work of regional and local chapters and that engage in political advocacy and fundraising, as well as many regional or local chapters that provide hands-on work. Cause-oriented individuals will also find opportunities for funding and employment. Another approach is to develop skills that are transportable between nonprofits with widely different missions. In larger organizations, and many smaller ones too, there are several essential positions including fundraisers, accountants, researchers, administrative assistants, and communication specialists. If you can develop experience in these areas, you have transportable skills where you can take your career to new heights. In contrast to nonprofits, for-profit organizations are driven by the bottom line of profits generated by selling products and services that others want. Unlike governments, for-profit businesses maintain direct control over their own budgets, personnel, and modes of production. While some for-profits are publicly owned and therefore must answer to shareholders, the managers of publicly owned companies still enjoy greater discretion than managers in government or nonprofit organizations. Besides traditional business opportunities, careers in the for-profit sector include positions in advertising, marketing, and management consulting. Hopefully, you have gained some useful information about your internship workplaces and the career fields you are choosing. But why just take it from me? For more insights from people who recently went through experiences similar to yours, be sure to read the career profiles offered in this module. What can Ernie Chung, Lisa Zabawa, and Edward Villacorta tell you that you don't already know? Check it out. In this lecture, we examine three broad job sectors within which most of your internships will fall. Our purpose was to identify some common norms and trends associated with each career sector in order to provide you a basic reference point as you start your internship. We will now turn to Bowman and Diehl's approach to common managerial leadership problems found in these sectors, with an eye to helping you assess your internship performance in the short and long term. The reframing organization's text will also help us examine the constraints and opportunities associated with professional development and organizational success.